Today I'm going to explain about gravity loading. Gravity loading do not differ from those in a low-rise building, but accumulated load because of number of stories is very much greater. Here, there won't be any difference between the high-rise building and low-rise building when it comes to gravity loading, but this accumulation of the load will be different, or it differs from stories to story. As we can see, in high-rise building the number of stories is more, and it is more than a low-rise building. As in a low-rise building, dead loading is calculated from designed member size and estimated material densities. We can calculate these dead loads by using the member size and estimated density of the members. The dead load can be calculated by taking these factors into consideration. Then, prone to minor inaccuracies such as differences between the real and the design size, and between the actual and the assumed densities. So as we saw in the second point, that we can, while calculating a dead load, we can use a member size as well as a density of the material. But when we come to the real condition, there may be a minor inaccuracies may occur. Because why this inaccuracies may occur is because there may be a difference between the real and the design size. Maybe while designing, we would have taken some size of the building, or while executing that, or during the construction, the size may differ in the real or actual site. So that is one a drawback. Then there may be a difference between the actual and assumed density. It may be a actual, or it may be a assumed. There will be a difference between these two while when it comes to a density part. Then it is, live loading is specified as the intensity of a uniformly distributed floor load according to the occupancy or use of the space. This live load is nothing but, we know live load is uniformly distributed floor load, or how much occupancy is there, how much it has been occupied, how much space is used. These things are important, or this is what the live load is called as. So this is one of the point in live loading. Then in certain situations such as the parking areas, offices and the plant rooms, the floors must be considered for the alternate worst possibility of specified concentrated load. While designing, especially while designing these parking lots or offices, plants room and the floor, we should design it for the worst possible conditions or worst possible cases. As we have seen, there may be a increase in number of vehicle, or there may be a more number of vehicle than we expect, and even in the offices and in the huge plants and all, the weight of the machineries may be a more, that can be unexpected, there can be unexpected weight. So these are the important things that has to be considered while designing it. Then the magnitude of live loading specified in the codes are estimated based on the combination of experience and results of the typical field survey. You can see in code book, we will come across few magnitude of the live loading. How these, in these code book, these values are decided is, it is, or how it is mentioned is, it is based on two conditions. One is based on the experience, based on the professor, researcher, or many experiments would have been conducted. Based on these things, their experience or their personal experience and maybe a results of the field survey, maybe because of these survey, maybe a practical thing, because of these results, they have arrived into a live loading magnitude conditions, and these values have been specified in the codebook based on these two things. Then the difference between the live load magnitudes in the code of different countries indicate a lack of unanimity and consistency sufficient to raise question about their accuracy. See, in different countries we come across different type of code books while designing any components or designing any buildings and all. That is because that they have different opinion, they have different thought process. They won't be agreeing to a few points which we agree. So there will be a difference of opinion. So there will be a there is like lot of questioning will be there when it comes to a loading conditions or magnitude country's condition and all. Based on these things, there will be a different opinion, and so only we are using different code in different countries while designing the buildings. So this is one of the major points. Then the pattern distribution of live gravity live loading over adjacent and alternate span should be considered in estimating the local maxima for member forces. While designing any member forces, we should consider the pattern of the distribution of the gravity live loading of adjacent alternate spans. Whatever is there, we should consider these things while estimating the local maxima of the member forces. Then the last point is, live load reduction may be allowed to account for the improbability of total loading being applied simultaneously over large areas. So the some live load reductions has to be applied. That is, in code book, when you refer earthquake 1893, you have a imposed load reduction factors that has to be imposed for the large area while calculating it. That has to be kept in mind, and it has to be designed. So this is also one of the point when we think about the gravity loading. So the overall summary is, gravity loading does not differs from building to building, but it differs when height of the stories get increased. Then a dead load calculation may differ based on the how the dead load is calculated is, it is by using the member size and by estimating the material density a dead load is considered. Then this, because there will be a difference in the real and the design size, and there will be a difference in actual and assumed density, there will be some minor inaccuracies while actually executing it. Then the live load is nothing but, it is a uniformly distributed floor load. It is nothing but the occupancy, how much space has been used. These comes under a live loading. Then while designing any plants or any office parking areas, we should keep in mind that it should be designed for the worst condition, which is unexpected. So keeping those points in mind, we should design it. Then magnitude of the live loading in the code book, which have been explained, it is depending on the experience and the results in the survey, and there will be a difference of opinion in each country. So only we are following different code book while designing the building. And while designing a local maxima for the member forces, design pattern of the live load of the adjacent span has to be considered, and live load reduction has to be applied while calculating for a larger area. Hope you have understood. Thank you.